Hello students, welcome to my class. In my last lecture, I was discussing about the Kohlrausch law. Today, I am going to discuss about the next section, that is galvanic cell or voltaic cell and the reaction occurring between them and the topic related to galvanic cell like potential, electrode potential, EMF, potential difference, oxidation potential, electrochemical series, lots of things are there, but we'll move one by one slowly because it is the matter of your career. Clear, my friend? So, let's start the topic. Now, my first topic of today's lecture is, that is my friend, electrochemical cell. Electrochemical cell. Am I right? Yes, sir. Now, as we know, electrochemical cell are those type of cell in which interconversion of energy take place. Either electrical energy, listen carefully what I'm telling. Either electrical energy converts into chemical energy or chemical energy converts into electrical energy. Wait for a moment. Clear to you? This is the function of electrochemical cell. Now, the types of electrochemical cells are, my friend, first one is electrolytic cell. The second one is, my friend, that is galvanic or voltaic. Galvanic or voltaic cell. Clear to you? These are the two types. As I discussed you, what is electrolytic cell? The type of cell in which the process of electrolysis is done. What is the electrolysis? When electricity is passed through the solution of an electrolyte, then electric energy, that is electric energy, brings chemical decomposition. Yes, sir, you have discussed it. Brings chemical decomposition. That is, electric energy converts into chemical energy. That is, in process of electrolysis, we require electricity. Electricity, and it's convert to, my friend, that is, it brings chemical decomposition. Am I right? Yes, sir. It brings chemical decomposition. Clear to you? Now, the thing is, in electrolytic cell, the electric energy converts into chemical energy. And we know for drawing a cell, for using the conversion, we need electrode. In case of electrolytic cell, we need two electrodes. First one is anode and the second one is cathode. As I discussed you earlier, anode has positive sign and cathode has a negative sign. Clear to you? And at anode, we people know oxidation take place. Yes, sir. And at cathode, reduction take place. Yes, sir. This is completely true. That is the thing. That is the configuration of electrolytic cell. Now, what about the galvanic cell, my friend? Galvanic or voltaic cell? The type of cell in which the chemical changes, chemical decomposition or chemical energy converts into electrical energy, my friend. That is, this is one of the important cell which brings electricity, which is used to generate electricity. For example, dry cell. In our torch, we use dry cell. And when we use dry cell, the torch glow. That is, chemical energy converts into electrical energy. Clear to you? So, there are two types of cell. Electrolytic cell, galvanic cell. What is galvanic or voltaic cell? The type of cell which brings the type of cell in which the chemical decomposition brings the electric energy, brings the electricity. Now the question arises, how a galvanic cell forms and what is the actual structure? So the typical example of galvanic cell, I'm drawing the structure, that is the Daniell cell. What is Daniell cell? As I told you earlier, in any cell there is the redox reaction take place, always redox reaction. That is oxidation as well as reduction take place. Now, what will happen in Daniell cell? Wait for a moment, give me few seconds, my friend. We take two separate container. Wait for a moment. What is Daniell cell? In Daniell cell there is two separate container in which the solution to different electrolytic solution was taken, to different chemicals are taken, that is in first container we have taken ZnSO4 as an electrolyte, yes sir. Now in second container, wait for a moment, we have taken CuSO4 as an electrolyte. Here that is the CuSO4 solution and ZnSO4 solution. Clear to you? Now mark them, that is 1 molar ZnSO4 solution and 1 molar CuSO4 solution. In ZnSO4 solution we dip a metal electrode. This metal electrode is made up of zinc, zinc metal electrode. Clear to you? And at CuSO4 we dip a metal electrode, that is Cu electrode, Zn and Cu electrode here. Clear to you? One by one, we will move slowly. Clear to you? Now, what will happen? These two container, these two separate container are connected by a medium, connected by salt bridge. What I'm telling? Connected by salt bridge. Clear, my friend? Now, what will happen it is found that when this circuit are completed, when we connect a bulb here, what will happen here? That is, the bulb glows. Why the bulb glows? That means to say definitely there is a flow of electron take place. What I'm telling? Definitely there is a flow of electron take place, and we know current is the flow of electrons. Now listen carefully, what will happen? It is found that electron starts flowing from zinc electrode to the copper electrode. What I'm telling, my friend, that is, electron start flowing from the zinc electrode towards the copper electrode. That means to say this electrode is electron rich. What I'm telling, that this electrode is electron rich. Listen carefully. And this and this are getting electron. So the current will start flowing from copper electrode to zinc electrode, because the conventional direction of current is from negative side, opposite to the flow of electron. That is, if the electron flows from zinc to copper electrode, then the current will flow from copper towards zinc electrode, and the bulb starts glowing. That means to say there is a chemical change take place which brings the chemical reaction. Now what will happen in this case? Zn converts to Zn2 plus and 2 electron. Clear to you? That is, the Zn electrode is electron rich. And Zn converts to Zn2 plus, that is, there is a release of electron take place. So at left side, Zn side, there is a oxidation take place. Am I right? There is a oxidation take place. So we will say that is Zn, in Zn electrode, the sign is here electron rich. So sign will be negative because it is electron rich, and oxidation take place. So this one is anode. Clear? And copper, that is definitely electron moving, that is plus sign, and this one is treated as, my friend, cathode. Now the question, sir, in electrolytic cell, anode had plus sign and cathode had negative sign, but in galvanic cell, anode will have negative sign and cathode will have positive sign. That is the difference. But at anode, there is always oxidation. At anode, there is always oxidation. Only sign changes, but the process remains same. At Zn side, there is oxidation take place. And copper side, Cu2 plus can take electron, convert to copper. That is, it is getting electron, and if anything gets electron, that the process is known as, my friend, reduction. So this side, reduction take place. So again, at cathode, reduction take place. At anode, oxidation take place. When these two container add linked by a salt bridge, then what will happen? Redox reaction take place. And this redox reaction, due to this redox reaction, the electricity generates. The electricity generates between the electrode and glow of bulb take place. Clear to you? Oxidation, reduction. So what is the basic difference between the sign of anode? In galvanic cell, the anode has negative sign. Why? Because this is a electron rich electrode, and electron has negative sign. Due to this reason, anodes are symbolized as negative sign in galvanic or voltaic or Daniell cell, and cathode here positive sign. But again, I am repeating, I am stressing, I am repeating these things because it is one of the most important thing. So at anode, what will happen? That is the oxidation take place. Process will not change. The first question. Question number one, what is given here? How would you determine the standard electrode potential of Mg2+? As we know, it is impossible to get the potential of single electrode system. To find the standard electrode potential of single electrode system, we have to couple it with SHE, standard hydrogen electrode. Then and then only we can get the standard electrode potential of any single electrode system. So what will happen in this case, we have to couple it, complete a cell, that is Mg2+, Mg, couple it with that is H plus. Suppose take 1 molar, clear to you, that is H2, 1 ATM, that is the platinum electrode. This is the case here, and here also take Mg+, clear my friend, that is. First of all, what to do? That is, we couple it with standard hydrogen electrode system. Now, for this reaction, we know the electrode potential of standard hydrogen potential is, my friend, that is equal to 0, yeah, because this is SHE. Now, what will happen? The reaction is like that. That is given here, Mg, clear to you? 2+, clear, that is Mg, clear my friend, solid form, and then there comes that is H+, 1 molar, then there is H2, 1 ATM, using platinum electrode. Now what will happen in this case, we will write here E naught cell is equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Clear to you? This is the formula. Do you remember? Yes. At cathode, we know that is the reduction take place. Yes. At anode, we people know there is oxidation take place. Clear to you? Now look at reduction. That is here, what is given here, that is H+ converted into H2, my friend. H+ converted into H2, that is, it is gaining 1 electron. If I balance, then I put here like this. Pardon. That is, we can write here 2H+ plus 2 electron, that is H2, my friend. Clear to you? This is the case. So EC, we can write here E naught H+ half H2, clear? And anode, we people know what is anode. In anode, there is, this is the reaction at cathode, my friend. Okay, cathode, there is a reduction, and we know we have to write the reduction terms, that is the case. And at anode, we know, my friend, that is the oxidation take place, yes? Oxidation take place. So in this case, what will happen? Mg gives you Mg2+, 1 molar given here. I have taken this, and this is, my friend, that is the electrode potential. So we'll write here Mg2+ and Mg. Clear, my friend? Now modifying the reaction, Mg. So the final cell reaction is like this, that is Mg solid gives you Mg2+ aqueous. I am taking here 1 molar solution. This is the case. Now as we know the value of the reduction potential of standard hydrogen potential, we know the value is 0. So put this value, what we get, E naught cell is equal to 0 minus E naught Mg2+ Mg. Clear to you? So finally we get E naught, that is standard reduction potential, electrode potential of Mg2 plus is minus standard electrode potential. This is the case, my friend. Clear? That is a complete explanation. So, to find the standard electrode potential of any single electrode system, couple it with SHE or NHE, standard hydrogen electrode or normal hydrogen electrode. This question is of 1 mark. This question may be of 2 marks or 3 marks. That's why I have given you the complete information related to this question. Clear? Now I'm going to rub this part and we'll discuss the next question. I think you have written this thing. Look at 0 minus minus the standard electrode system. And we know in each and every case we take the reduction potential, not oxidation potential. That's why I have modified the formula, and during my lecture I have also discussed E naught C minus E naught A. Let's move to the next segment of the question. What is the next question? Listen carefully, my friend. Now, this is the question number 2. Why does the conductivity of the solution decreases with dilution? Clear? As we know, conductivity of a solution is conductance of ions per unit volume. Yes, sir. This is the case. What will happen on dilution? The number of ions per unit volume decreases. Again, I am repeating, the number of ions per unit volume decreases. Due to this reason, the conductivity of the solution decreases with dilution. Conductivity of the solution decreases with dilution. Clear? This is the case, my friend. Conductivity of a solution is conductance of ions per unit volume. That is, on dilution, number of ions per unit volume decreases. Due to this reason, my friend, conductivity decreases. Simple explanation, 1 marks question. Clear? Now I'm going to rub this part and we'll discuss the next question. Wait for a moment. Let's move to the next segment of the question. What is the next segment? Check this thing. This is a question. Question number 3. Read the question carefully, my friend. Predict the relation between the following is feasible. Predict if the reaction between the following is feasible. Is it feasible or not? For the feasibility of a reaction, we know if E naught cell comes positive, then we can say the reaction is feasible. This is the important thing. The reaction is feasible. E naught cell comes positive, the reaction is feasible. Now check it out. The first case is given here, the reaction between Fe3 plus and what is given here, my friend, I minus. This is the case. Now what will happen? Check it out. That is Fe3 plus plus I minus. It gives you, my friend, Fe2 plus plus I2. This is the reaction, my friend. Yes, complete reaction. Now, Fe3 plus converted to Fe2 plus. Yes, this is the reduction. Yes, sir, this is the reduction. Now I minus, wait for a moment, I minus converted to I2. This is my friend oxidation. Now we know what I'm telling, we know E naught cell is equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. As we know, in cathode there is a reduction take place. Yes sir, that is, and at anode we know there is a oxidation take place. Now that is, we have to consider the oxidation reduction. That is, we will write here E naught Fe 3 plus to Fe 2 plus minus E naught, that is I minus, clear to you, I minus, that is half I2. Now the case here is given, that is in terms of reduction potential it is given. So put the value in terms of reduction potential, that is half I2 and I minus. Now put the value Fe3 plus, that is plus 0.77. Now put here E naught cell is equal to my friend, that is the case here, that is Fe3 plus, that is 0.77 minus what is I2, that is 0.541. This is case. Now what I am getting, we are getting positive value my friend. We are getting E naught cell, definitely this one is the bigger one, bigger minus a smaller, that is we get positive value. If we get positive value, then we can say the reaction is my friend feasible. So the reaction, if it gets negative value, the reaction is not feasible. Now again I am taking the, I am moving here my friend, check it out. The second one is given here, Ag plus aqueous form and Cu, this is the case. Now what will happen, the reaction between them happens like this, Ag plus aqueous plus Cu, that is Ag and Cu2 plus, balance them, 2Ag, 2Ag plus Cu, Cu2 plus, so charge balance, clear to you. Now what will happen, look at, Cu converted to Cu2 plus my friend, definitely this is oxidation, yes sir. Now Ag plus converted to Ag, then definitely this one is my friend reduction, yes sir, this one is reduction. Now what we need to find, that is E naught cell, E naught cell is equal to cathode minus anode. Now cathode, that is the reduction, reduction of, that is E naught Ag plus converted to Ag, clear to you, Ag plus Ag minus anode. What is anode here, that is Cu, put here the reduction potential term, Cu2 plus to Cu. Now get the value from here, that is Cu2 plus, that is 0.34, and Ag in this case, that is 0.80. What we get here my friend, E cell is equal to plus 0.46, and if I get plus 0.46, that is the positive value here. So we can say again the reaction is feasible my friend. These are the method to find out the feasibility of the reaction. So what I am telling, if the reaction is feasible, if the standard electrode potential, that is E naught cell, comes positive, and positive the formula is E naught C minus Ea, clear my friend, check out the things, these are very simple and you can easily solve such kind of questions. Now I'm going to wrap this part and we'll discuss